Hello and welcome to another presentation on the DFM, Design for Manufacturing series. This presentation will focus on the yield sensitivity histograms. And as you can see from the slide, just like design of experiments, which we have shown in another presentation video, this yield sensitivity histograms also acts as the X-ray, what we call the X-ray, of circuit design. Basically, if you have a circuit design that has a low yield or have some problems in manufacturing, the yield sensitivity histograms and the design of experiments will pinpoint to you. They are the X-ray machine. They will pinpoint to you where the problem is coming from and will help you solve the problem to get much higher yield and consistent designs. So let's see how this works. This is the process, the DFM process for MMIC, where you start your design, statistical design, start your nominal design, optimize and center your design, and then you get to this step in yellow called Monte Carlo yield analysis. So Monte Carlo yield analysis tells you there is a problem in the design. Your yield is low. But then what? How do you fix it? How do you know where the problem's coming from? And this is exactly the purpose of this presentation. It's discussing with you the sensitivity, yield sensitivity histograms, which will help you pinpoint and find out where the problem is coming from. Okay, so when designers run Monte Carlo yield analysis on their circuit, ADS generates lots of useful data. There is all kinds of data that are accumulated and saved in a data set based on all the variations and all the Monte Carlo yield runs. So ADS data display, the next step here, has the capability to post-process all these data. And this is what happened with the yield sensitivity histograms here. It takes the Monte Carlo yield analysis, it post-processes the data from the yield analysis data, it post-processes this data and generates the yield sensitivity histograms to find the sensitive components for you. So, yield sensitivity histogram basically displays the overall yield of the circuit with respect to any component in the design while all other components are being varied at the same time. So if you look at the graph here, the x-axis here could be a component, resistor, nominal value in the center, and the resistor has a tolerance plus or minus 10%. And it's telling you if the resistor is nominal value here at the center, the y-axis will read for you the yield, the overall yield, while everything in the circuit is varying. So notice if the resistor goes down minus 10% of its nominal value, the yield of the circuit goes higher, where if the resistor goes higher, the yield drops to zero. So it really tells you a lot of information here, and it's very, very accurate based on all the Monte Carlo yield analysis run you have done. So yield sensitivity histogram help you pinpoint the sensitive, we call it red X, part in the design. And then once you find out these red X parts in the design, designers then make decision to either replace these parts with tighter tolerance parts. Like if you have a board design, not an IC design, a board, you can purchase parts that has much tighter tolerance, less sensitive, by paying a little bit of extra money on those parts. Or if you have an IC design where you cannot change components, you can make wise decisions on some components. And if you cannot, you can change the whole matching network to yield a less sensitive matching network for your design. I'll show you next how this is done. Here's an example to illustrate this whole concept. We have a VCO design that has about 10 components. And you can see this is the transistor. It's a bipolar transistor BFQ67. We're even using 21 different measured transistors when we run the yield analysis. And we're varying all the components, the lumped components, 5% uniform variation in all the lumped components. These are my specs. I want power output to be greater than 4 dBm. I want the phase noise to be less than minus 85 dBc at 10 kHz offset, and the frequency of oscillation to be between 1975 to 2025 MHz. And this is the capacitors along with the inductor, you know, the resonator. We ran Monte Carlo yield analysis, and the yield came out to be 37.5%. based on the specs that I have shown you. So we go ahead and plot what I told you about before, the yield sensitivity histogram on every component in the design. So you can see I have 10 components. Each graph illustrates the yield sensitivity histogram relative to that component displayed on the x-axis. Notice that most of the components shown in blue, or all of them shown in blue, the yield is flat, it's horizontal, as the component on the x-axis changes plus or minus 5% around its nominal value. This is really tells me that for this component, if you change the component plus or minus 5%, the yield does not really vary. It's horizontal, it's flat. But if you look at the first component on the top left in red, notice that if I change that component plus or minus 5%, my yield drops down close to zero. So it is a sensitive component. And let me zoom on that component to talk about it furthermore. This is the component, and we found out that it is the inductor of the tank circuit, the L resonator 1, LRES 1, is the red X component. The nominal value is about 4.5 nanohenry on the x-axis, it's shown. And as we vary it, plus or minus 5%, you can see the yield of the whole oscillator drops down close to zero at the edges. And this is the red X component. This is the troubled component that is causing the low yield. So we take this inductor, LRES1, and we try to screen that component, to screen it. And when we screen it, we choose an inductor that has probably a variation plus or minus 1%, or plus or minus 3% instead of 5%. So we pay extra money for screening, but at least we identified, you know, this component that's giving us problem. And now we pay a little bit extra money to screen that component and tighten the tolerance on that component. So we went ahead and did that. Look at the top title of this. We get higher yield now by controlling the inductor plus or minus 1% instead of plus or minus 5%. Look, the yield doubled. It went up to 70.4%. Now we do the same thing, the yield sensitivity histogram for all the elements. And notice on the top left, the inductor now is flat. We solved this problem. But guess what? Something showed up right now as we fixed the inductor and the yield got higher. Something which was buried before down, we could not see it, but now it is shown clearly as the yield went higher. This capacitor, CRES1, has the same problem. It is sensitive component and it is causing low yield as it goes to minus 5%. So you can see the yield is going down. You see, before the yield was low, that CRES1, we couldn't see that effect. But as we fixed from the inductor, as we fixed the yield up,